Hey, what's up, guys? In the last video, someone asked how we put blood in our Ivan heads. Well, on the bottom here, there's this tube which leads all the way into the cranial cavity. So we just turn it upside down, fill it up with blood, and the cool thing about the diameter of this tube is that a wine cork fits in there perfectly, which keeps the blood from spilling out.
Have you ever wondered what would happen if you mixed Mythbusters with The Walking Dead? We are Zombie Go Boom, filmmakers and zombie survival enthusiasts. Using our scientifically accurate zombie heads, we put retail weapons, homemade weapons, and everyday objects to the test in order to see what will save you during the zombie apocalypse. Survive, protect, and kick undead ass.
Alright, so in order to get Tim to look more like the Donald, we're gonna have to get the right skin tone. Pretty sure this is actually how Donald Trump does it. Looks just like the real thing. Welcome to another mind-blowing episode from Zombie Go Boom. I'm Chuck Murray.
I'm Charles Foltz.
And today we're going to be killing zombie Donald Trump with weapons that are relevant to the content of his character that are also weapons that you've wanted us to test for a very long time. What's the first weapon?
This part of a wall, otherwise known as a brick.
Second weapon are these brass knuckles, because he's always talking about going fisticuffs with people.
And the last weapon will be this 9-iron golf club, because he likes to go golfing with the Clintons.
That's right, and this is a versus episode, and to be fair, we're going to be testing each weapon 3 times in 3 different ways, and we're going to be declaring a victor at the end. Also, this is the first episode of our Zombie Fight Celebrity series, where we kill zombies that look like celebrities, public figures, or popular characters.
Let's get started.
The first weapon we have for you today is a brick. A brick is a building material used to make walls. The greatest walls. Nothing is better at making walls than a huge brick. Bricks were originally made of clay, and thus were very brittle. Modern day bricks are made out of all sorts of materials and can therefore be very tough. Today, we will be using a perforated and keyed engineering brick. It is incredibly hard, ridiculously dense, and not porous in the slightest. Normally, a brick would break against an Ivan head, but this particular kind of brick may just have a shot. The second weapon we'll be testing are some brass knuckles or knuckle dusters. Since we know fists aren't enough to kill a zombie, maybe a little metal can help the endeavor. Due to their legality, the ones we will be testing today are actually sold as belt buckles, and they feature a nice leather wrap on the palm side. These bad boys are also made in the land of most of the Donald's merchandise. Hint, not America. The third weapon today is this Tracker mid-size 9-iron golf club. The Donald would probably laugh at the poor quality of this club, but we bought it at a thrift store, so whatever. The head is steel, the shaft is aluminum, and the grip is rubberized fiberglass. And out of all of the weapons today, we think this may have the best shot at killing zombie Donald due to the leverage and speed one can generate with it. Which weapon will win? Vote by checking out the poll on the top right corner of this video.
3, 2...
All right, we're about to... Shit. I was trying to be fancy.
3, 2...
All right, we're about to get started with the brick, but before we do, I want to remind you guys that we have a current giveaway going on alongside Gizmo Slip, where you can pick any phone you want or any video game console you want, and to enter that giveaway, just check out the link in the description below. Now, let's move on to this. I'm going to be hitting it in 3 ways. First way, basically palm heel sort of strike to the side of the head. Then I'm just gonna do the same thing, except I'm gonna flatten it out. And then lastly, I'm gonna come across and hit him that way. Let's get started. We got some scrapes on the side of his skin, but that's about it. He has a really thick skull.
Knock you out.
sounded like it first.
Yeah. If you're a human, concussion for sure. Maybe hemorrhaging, maybe death. For a zombie, I mean, just a loud bang and that's about it. Let's try this strike right here and see if we can send Donald Trump back to Willy Wonka's chocolate factory. I got a fracture. Do you want to feel it? Right there.
Oh, yep.
All right, so we have a fractured skull, big time fractured. If you're a human being, you're in the hospital, you have serious injuries, you have a concussion, you probably have some hemorrhaging, you're probably dead. If you're a zombie, pick your fiction. Some movies or video games and books will tell you you'd be dead. Some will tell you that you would be totally fine. But this part right here is pretty well compromised. Around the temporal bone right there is broken. And the temporal bone is actually the thinnest part of the skull. So it makes sense that that was the one that actually broke before anything else. So for the remaining tests, we're going to be trying... sorry, Donald! For the remaining tests, we're going to be trying the other side of the head. Another thing to say about it is one would wet. 3, 2. Another thing to say about it is one good whack with the... Oh my god, it's so cool. All right, let's go again. Another thing I'd like to add is one good whack with the brick and the zombie is down on the ground, so it's gonna make it a lot easier for you to be able to finish it off.
All right, up next is the brass knuckles. First, I'm gonna give him a shot right here to the jaw, try to disable it so he can't talk any more shit. Then I'm gonna punch him in the temple. Hopefully that'll get into his skull. If it doesn't work, I'm gonna hammer fist straight to the top of his head. And in my opinion, hammer fisting is the way you're supposed to use brass knuckles. Otherwise, you could injure yourself. He might have a dislocated jaw, or maybe a fractured jaw, but the problem is the brass knuckles move whenever you punch something with it this way, so that really hurts. All right, that didn't do anything, because he's got a thick fucking skull, so we're gonna do the hammer fist now. I don't think he's doing anything. It's too much padding.
His hair's providing too much padding. It's like a helmet. It's a hair helmet. A hermit.
So, the brass knuckles are a little bit better than punching the zombie bare-fisted, but not by much. The brick did a lot better. Next, we're gonna be testing the golf club. All right, up next, the golf club, but we're gonna hit it with this end. I know it's not the traditional way you use a golf club, but we're gonna try it anyway. Then, I'm gonna hit it with this side, then I'm gonna turn it around and hit it with this side. Let's do it. All right, handle is broken. I'm gonna grab it here now. Let's do it. Ah, that sounded like it hurt. Let's check it out. Nope.
Nothing.
No broken bones. Let's try this end.
Still, no broken bones. I think that wig is just super magical or something.
All right, so most of those weapons did not work hardly at all because Donald Trump's head is just too thick. So now the question is, can he feel the burn? Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed that video from Zombie Go Boom. The brass knuckles definitely do not get the Zombie Go Boom seal of approval.
The golf club? Nope.
The brick actually does get the ZGB seal of approval. The break on Donald Trump's head was actually pretty massive and could definitely have killed a zombie, especially if we would have kept going. Make sure you punch the living crap out of that like button and subscribe, that helps a lot. I'm Chuck Murray.
I'm Charles Fulp.
And we will see you next time. Look at the hair. You gotta get a shot of the back of this, it's hilarious.